This video introduces CMOS logic gates and their implementation using PMOS and NMOS transistors. No assumptions are made about your knowledge of analog electronics or circuit elements or electromagnetics in this video. So the first logic gate that we want to look at here is the inverter. One thing about our circuit that we need to think about is fundamentals. At the top here, we have a voltage rail, and at the bottom, we have a voltage rail. Now, these voltage rails have many common names in implementations. We're going to refer to them in this video as the logic 1 rail right here and the logic 0 rail down here. Now, other names for these logic rails that we may see, the logic 1 rail could be called VDD, it could be called VCC. We could see actual voltage levels such as plus 5 volts, plus 3.3 volts. I've seen PV or P3V3, P5V3, etc. For logic 0, a very common name for logic 0 is ground, or GND, VSS, what else is another one? VEE. So some common names that you might see. For the remainder of the video, we're just going to refer to these logic rails as logic 1 and logic 0, the voltage rails as logic 1 and logic 0 respectively. So in the inverter, what does an inverter do? Well, the inverter converts a logic 1 to a logic 0 and vice versa. So there is one input here called A and one output here called Y. Now, when the A input is set to 0, let's think about the operation of the PMOS and NMOS transistors again. If we have an input of a logic 0 or low voltage to the PMOS transistor, then it is connected. So the high voltage rail, the logic 1, is connected to the output Y, and electrical current flows from the logic 1 rail to the output Y. Also, when we have an input 0 on A, then the NMOS transistor is disconnected from the logic 0 rail. So current flows from the logic 1 rail to Y, and current is disconnected, or the logic rail 0 is disconnected from Y, so no current flows from Y to 0. So Y, when we have an input 0, gives us an output, we get an output of 1. Now, what happens when we take the input A and set it to 1 instead here? So if we have an input 1, the PMOS transistor is disconnected. So A is logic 1, it's a high voltage. The PMOS is disconnected, and the NMOS connects Y to the voltage rail of logic 0. So any electrical current that needs to flow will flow from the logic rail, will flow from output Y to logic rail zeros. So the output Y is equal to logic 0. The symbol for the inverter is shown here. Okay. There is a more complicated circuit that we can build. Instead of just converting zeros to ones and ones to zeros, we can actually do more complicated logic. So, some basic fundamentals that we need to consider in this circuit. First of all, we have a power rail at the top, which we label logic 1, power rail at the bottom, which we will label logic 0. All right. We have an input A, and we have a second input B. Now notice that A is connected to this PMOS transistor and this NMOS transistor, whereas the logic B input is connected to here and here. Now, while there is no clearly drawn connection between the NMOS and PMOS transistors that are labeled B, we consider the label B as a virtual connection. So, one other structural aspect that we should notice is that the NMOS transistors here are connected in series. So, any current that needs to flow from Y here to the lower power rail here, it needs to flow through both the NMOS transistors. So they are connected in series here because there will be a low resistance from Y to the power rail of zero, at the logic zero, if both A and B are set to 1. And there will be a low resistance for the PMOS in parallel now. So PMOS, we have one here and one here. These are connected in what's called parallel. So there is a low resistance if A is not equal to 1, or if B is not equal to 1. So remember that here, in series, the connection has to be through both of them. If you want Y to connect to the 0, then both the NMOS transistors need to be connected. However, if Y needs to connect to logic 1 here instead, then it can connect through either the A PMOS or the B PMOS transistor. So this interesting circuit here has a different kind of truth table, and we call it the NAND gate. Now, why is it called a NAND gate? Well, let's look at all the possible input combinations. We have two inputs, A and B. And these inputs can be either 0 or 1. So we have two inputs, two possible values for each. So we have 2 times 2 for 4 possible inputs. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4 entries in our truth table. Okay, so let's enumerate all the possibilities. A is 0, B is 0. What happens when A is 0 and B is 0? Well, this is connected, A PMOS is connected, and B PMOS is connected. If A is 0, the A NMOS is disconnected, and if B is 0, the B NMOS is disconnected. Therefore, Y is connected to an output level of 1. Okay, so that covers one entry. What happens when A is 0 and B is 1? If A is 0, then the A PMOS is connected and the A NMOS is disconnected. If B is 1, then the B PMOS is disconnected and the B NMOS is connected. Notice, current stops flowing at this NMOS transistor here, the A NMOS transistor. Bam, it's a wall. So nothing flows through this electrical transistor here, this NMOS transistor. However, current flows from our logic 1 rail, right, to our Y output. Let's label the power and ground rails again. So we have an output of 1 at Y. Again, so this covers two inputs. Let's take a look at when A is 1 and B is 0. If A is 1, the A PMOS transistor is disconnected and the A NMOS is connected. If B is 0, then the B PMOS connects and the B NMOS disconnects. So current flows from the logic 1 rail power rail to Y, so we have an output 1 yet again. So let's look at our last case when we have an input of 1 for both A and B. So A is 1 and B is 1. If A is 1, we have a disconnection on the A PMOS and a connection on the A NMOS. If B is 1, we have a disconnection on the B PMOS and a connection on the B NMOS. And in this case, we finally see an instance where Y is connected through the NMOS transistors through to the ground rails, so we have finally an output 0 on Y. Now, if we look closely, if A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 1 then Y is equal to 0. In other words, it's not 1. This would be a good way to explain it. So this is the functionality of, here, the NAND gate. The NAND gate. We see the symbol for the NAND gate here. Okay. Another more complicated circuit that you can consider is this 4-transistor circuit here, which is fairly similar to the NAND gate from before. Notice that here, the NMOS transistors are in parallel, and the PMOS transistors are in series this time. So for Y to connect to our logic 1 rail, both PMOS transistors need to be connected. Both the A PMOS and the B PMOS transistor need to be connected. This one and this one both need to be connected for our logic 1 to connect to Y. However, if we wish to connect Y to an output 0, our logic level 0 down here, then we need to connect either this NMOS transistor or this NMOS transistor here, either the A NMOS or the B NMOS. So this is the NOR gate implementation. So how does it work? Well, let's remind ourselves what the logic levels are, what these power rails represent in logic, digital logic. And let's say we have a logic 0 on A and a logic 0 on B. So this means that we have a connection through the A PMOS and the B PMOS transistors. Also, it means that the A NMOS and the B NMOS are both disconnected. So current flows from the logic 1 power rail to the output Y, and we get a logic 1 output. For A equals 0, B equals 1, we see that we have a connection for the A PMOS and no connection for the B PMOS. We also have no connection for the A NMOS, but we have a connection for the B NMOS. Therefore, Y doesn't connect to the 1, a logic 1, because it stopped here at the BPMOS. Y is connected to logic 0 through the BNMOS transistor here. So we have an output logic level of 0. So, whoops. What about input 1, 0? A equal to 1, B equal to 0. Well, let's analyze it. B is BPMOS transistor connected. A PMOS transistor is disconnected. So Y is not connected to the logic 1 rail yet again. However, the A NMOS is connected, while the B NMOS is disconnected. Therefore, Y connects to logic 0 through the A NMOS transistor. So output at Y is 0 again. Let's look at our final case, A equal to 1, B equal to 1. So if A equals 1 and B equals 1, then both PMOS transistors are disconnected and both NMOS transistors are connected. Therefore, Y connects to the logic 0 rails through both NMOS transistors. So again, we're going to have a logic 0 output. And this is our implementation of the NOR gate drawn here. So if A is equal to 1 or B is equal to 1, then Y is equal to 0, not 1. else, y is equal to 1, not 0. So notice that for the NAND gate, going back, we use the word AND here. And for the NOR gate, we use the word OR. There are some other logic gates that we can actually develop. So we have the OR gate here. And notice that the outputs are the inversions of the NOR. So let's take a look back here at the NOR gate here. Notice that we have outputs 1 0 0 1 0 0 0. This is for input 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1, respectively. So if we look here, instead of 1 0 0 0, we now have 0 1 1 1. So for comparison, let's write out the NOR here. 1 0 0 0. So a NOR gate can be thought of as the inversion, or the OR gate can be thought of as the inversion of the NOR. Similarly, let's look at the NAND gate. The NAND, if we go back, we see the inputs here, or the outputs 1 1 1 0, respectively. Let's go ahead and place these here, 1 1 1 0. Notice that the NAND gate and the AND gate have a relationship by the inverter. So the AND gate here is related to the NAND gate by an inverter. We can implement the AND gate using a NAND gate and an inverter then, like so. So we have the implementation of the OR gate and the AND gate, and what do they mean? Well, what is an OR gate? If A is 0, or if A is 1, or if A is 1, or B is 1, then the output is 1. Otherwise, it's 0. For the AND gate, if A is 1 and B is 1, then the output is 1. Otherwise, it's 0 again. Some other logic gates that you will come across include the exclusive OR gate or XOR gate right here. Now the logic truth table that takes two inputs. So if you have an input 1 on either A or B but not both, then you will get an output of 1. Otherwise, you will get an output of 0. So 0, 0, input 0, 0, and input 1, 1 both give outputs of 0 for the exclusive OR. For exclusive NOR, this is the opposite of exclusive OR. So if A is equal to 1 or B is equal to 1 but not both, it's equal to 0. Otherwise, the output is equal to 1. So 0, 0 outputs 1, 1, 1 outputs 1. Another name might be the equivalence gate. So it's looking at the values of both A and B to see if they are equal. So digital logic, inverters, AND gates, and OR gates are very fundamental to implementing higher-level circuitry, higher-level digital circuitry. But these can represent the Boolean algebra that is developed in your logic class. So for not A or A prime, we can use the inverter. This is equivalent to not A. For the AND gate, this is like calculating A and B. For the OR gate, this is like calculating A or B, right? And in Boolean algebra, we use fundamentally inversion, conjunction, and disjunction. Inversion, conjunction, and disjunction. Not and or. So other ways to describe it are A prime, A anded with B, written as a multiplication, A ored with B, written as an addition. So we have an exclusive OR gate and exclusive NOR gate, Boolean algebra equations here. So plus with a circle and the equivalent symbol. And when we put them all together, we can get a diagram like this. So in this diagram, we take inputs C here and D. And this is placed through an OR gate right here. So we have C or D. The output of that is passed into an AND gate with A here. So A is ANDed with C or D. Now this output is passed through an inverter then, which is inverted by this prime symbol. Next we look at the digital circuit. We see that we take signals B and E here. This goes through an AND gate. So we can say B ANDed with E here. The outputs of these two subcircuits here and here go to an OR gate. So these are both combined with our OR symbol here. And we have a circuit for implementing a Boolean algebra equation.